I grew up watching Kobe Bryant, game after game, ring after ring, living his greatness without apology. I wanted to be just like him, to love every part of the competition, to be the first to show up and the last to leave, to love the grind, to be your best when you don't feel your best, and make other people around you the best version of themselves, and to wake up and do it again the next day. So that's what I did. Wake up, grind, and get better. Wake up, grind, and get better. I ask each of you, every girl dad, every human here with a voice, a platform, and a heart, to not let his sun set. Shine for us, for our sport, where he once did. Invest in us with the same passion and drive and respect and love as he did his own daughter.
Well, Kobe Bryant has been selected as a member of the Hall of Fame class of 2020, and his legacy certainly will live on forever. There are countless on-court stories about Kobe, how he handled the ball, his shooting, the Mamba mentality. But perhaps his most recent work off the court is the inspiration that many will hold on to. As Maria Taylor and other voices of basketball tell us in the following story, women's basketball's biggest ally was Kobe Bryant.
Lost potentially the greatest ally that this sport could ever hope for.
He was the one that was providing legitimacy to our game. Other people didn't see that. He was changing that narrative.
I would say the most important imprint he's left is just having us feel equal. I mean, he believed in women's sports.
What defines a legacy? Is it stats? Championships, a mindset? Kobe Bryant had it all. But for women's basketball, perhaps the most important thing he left behind is inspiration.
As a WNBA player, every day we face so many stigmas and stereotypes. That entire narrative that women are less than, women don't deserve visibility, that was going away with Kobe just simply walking into arena and cheering us on.
He came to a lot of our games. He was at our All-Star game last year. He went to UConn games. Now that everyone knows how he was mentoring and sponsoring these elite women athletes in the WNBA, I think Kobe's legacy helps us be more innovative around that.
What can I say? Mamba out.
I think the minute he was finished playing, it was, okay, I took everything out of this game that I could possibly take. How do I help other players get better? This incredible amount of women's basketball players had a chance to work with him. And they came away thinking, he's a fan. And he wants us to get better. And he stays in contact with you. Hey, I watched you play the other night. Who does that? He did.
This was a second act for Kobe. Why would he say to Adam Silver, I don't want to talk about the NBA, I want to talk about the WNBA, and I want to meet the new commissioner.
It was just in his DNA to try to be great at everything. I think we only saw it through the lens of basketball for so long. He was like, okay, I'm transitioning from giving my all on the court to giving my all to my daughters.
It was huge for him. He wanted to be the best father, but also the best coach that he could. And so I think through his daughter, he was able to do that.
As we learn to accept what the sports world is like without him, one thing is certain. Kobe Bryant may have just been scratching the surface, and his legacy will continue to ignite the popularity of women's hoops.
He wanted to do more. He wanted to get more involved. He wanted to expand Mamba Academy and just add more layers to it. With those kids, the imprint is immeasurable. You know, they don't remember as much Kobe, the guy fist pumping because he just won an NBA championship. They remember him sitting on the bench trying to get them to be better.
He's always respected and co-signed our game. Him coming to our games, him bringing his daughter, has truly helped our game grow in ways that we didn't even imagine. Now we have so many people that should be warriors and people that want to carry on his legacy forever. And that's the beauty in the tragedy.
Such a beautiful look at the lasting legacy Kobe Bryant had on the game of women's basketball. For more on Kobe, we want to send things back out to New Jersey to WNBA Commissioner Kathy Engelbert.
Thanks, Ryan. We all know that Kobe was a huge advocate of the WNBA and women and girls basketball, as you just saw. Some would say he was just getting started in what would have been a meaningful second act around that advocacy. And we all know that Gigi was on a course to play a role in the future of women's basketball. The WNBA would like to carry on their legacy, and I am honored to announce tonight the debut of the Kobe and Gigi Bryant WNBA Advocacy Award. This award will recognize an individual or group who has made significant contributions to the visibility, perception, and advancement of women's and girls' basketball at all levels, like Kobe was so committed to doing. The Kobe and Gigi Bryant WNBA Advocacy Award is a call to action for advocates to use their time, talent, and platform to raise awareness for the game. The league and our partners will make a charitable contribution in the recipient's name to further advance the game. The WNBA and the Bryant family expect to announce the inaugural recipient of the award during the NBA All-Star Weekend in 2021. We look forward to seeing who will carry the torch in years to come. Thank you, WNBA out.